In this lesson, we are going to see about sound. Okay, let us start. Sound is a vibration that propagates a wave through a transmission medium such as gas, liquid or solid. We hear variety of sounds in our daily life, like thundering of clouds, tripping of birds, mewing of cats, rustling of leaves and music on the radio or television and noise of some vehicles. All these sounds we are familiar with. Each sound has particular characteristics. Sound enables us to communicate with each other. Animals also communicate with other members of their own species. Some sounds like music are pleasing to us to hear. Some sounds, for example, noise in our surroundings is undesired to hear. Okay. Production of sound. Sound is produced when an object is said to vibrate. Vibration means a kind of rapid to and fro motion of a particle. This to and fro motion of a particle causes the substance around it to vibrate. Thus, sound spreads to the surroundings. Substance through which sound is transmitted from one place to another is called as a medium. Sound moves to the medium from the listener. We can understand the production of sound with the help of some activities. Let us see one by one. Let us begin with the activity. Take the tray of an empty matchbox and stretch the rubber band around it along its length. Then plunk the stretched rubber band with your fingers. What do you observe? Do you hear any sound? Or plucking the rubber band, it starts vibrating. You can hear a humming sound as long as the rubber band gets vibrating. The humming sound stops. Okay, as soon as the rubber band stops vibrating, this confirms that sound is produced by vibrating particles. You can see this kind of vibration in stringed musical instruments such as guitar and sitar also. Next activity, take a metal shallow pan, hang it at a convenient place in such a way that it does not touch anything else, as you can see. Now strike it with a stick. Touch the pan gently with your finger. Do you feel any vibration? Yes. Again strike the pan with the stick and hold it tightly with your hands immediately after striking. Do you still hear the sound? Yes. This activity shows that vibrating pan produces sound. In this case, we can felt by touching the pan. This is also one of the vibration which is produces from the sound. Okay. Next activity, take a metal dish and pour some water into it. Strike at the edge with the spoon. Do you hear any sound? Again, strike the dish and touch it. Can you feel the dish is getting vibrating? Yes, you can see the surface of the water. Do you see any other movement on the water surface? Now, hold the dish with your hands. Any change do you observe on the surface of the water? Yes, the activity shows that the sound is produced when the object is said to vibrate. The sound produced by the vibration is propagated from one location to another. When it reaches our ear, we hear the sound. Next one is propagation of sound. We can go with the example for this propagation of sound. When you call your friend who is standing at a distance, your friend is able to hear your voice. How your friend is able to hear your voice? He is able to hear because your sound travels from one place to another. We know that the sound is a form of energy that needs a medium to travel. So it is clearly shows that sound needs a medium to travel. Example for the propagation of sound. Take a bell jar and a mobile phone. Switch on the music in the mobile phone and place it inside the jar. Now pump out the air which is present in the bell jar by using the vacuum pump. As more and more air is removed from the jar, the sound from the mobile phone becomes feebler and finally very less. It is clear from this experiment that sound cannot travel in vacuum and it needs a medium like air. Sound travels in water and solids also. The speed of the sound is more in solids than in liquids and it is very less in gases. Another example, take two stones and strike them together and listen to the sound produced by them. Now take the stones under the water and strike them. You will find what the sound produced by the sound underwater is feeble and not very clear. The speed of the sound is the distance traveled by the sound in 1 second and it is denoted by the letter V. And it is represented by the expression V is equal to N lambda, where N is the frequency and lambda is the wavelength. The speed of the sound depends on the properties of the medium through which it travels, like temperature, pressure and humidity. In any medium, as the temperature increases, the speed of the sound is also increases. In order to understand, let us consider a vibrating tuning fork. When a vibrating tuning fork moves forward, it pushes and compresses the air in front of it, creating a region of high pressure. This region is called as compression. When it moves backward, it creates a region of low pressure called rarefaction. This compression and rarefaction produces the sound wave which propagates through the medium. Sound waves. Sound is a form of energy. It is transferred through the air or any other medium in the form of mechanical waves. Mechanical wave is a disturbance which produces or propagates in a medium due to the repeated periodic motion of the particle of the medium from their mean position. The disturbance from which it is caused by the vibration of the particle is passed over to the next particle. It means that the energy is transferred from one particle to another particle as a wave motion. For example, a thrown stone in a pool of still water, it produces the waves which produces rapidly over the surface of the water and travel in all the directions.
Check out this speaker. If we plug it in, it makes sound. The way this speaker creates sound is by moving the front of the speaker, which is called the diaphragm, back and forth rapidly. Scientists often use the word oscillation to refer to the back and forth motion of an object. This speaker's oscillating too fast for the human eye to see, but if I put a piece of paper on the speaker, we see that because the diaphragm is oscillating, it's bumping into this piece of paper and causing it to dance. The oscillation of the diaphragm will also cause the air in front of the diaphragm to move back and forth. But here's the interesting thing, the air in front of the diaphragm doesn't actually travel away from the speaker. The air molecules in front of the speaker just oscillate back and forth. So how can you hear the sound from a speaker if the air next to the speaker doesn't actually make it to your ear? Well, the reason is that the oscillating air in front of the speaker causes the air in front of it to also oscillate. This causes the air in front of that air to start oscillating, which causes the air in front of it to start to oscillate, until finally the air that's actually next to your ear and your eardrum start to oscillate back and forth. This oscillating air that's next to your ear is moving, so it has kinetic energy. So it can transfer energy into your eardrum, which you can perceive as sound. So this speaker was able to transport energy through the air without actually having to transport the air itself. This is an important enough fact for me to state again. Energy is traveling across the room here, but air itself is not traveling across the room. Only the disturbance within the air is traveling across the room. If air were being transported across the room, it'd be better characterized not as sound, but as wind. So this is why we call sound a sound wave, because it shares the defining feature of waves, which is being able to transport energy through a medium without having to transport the medium itself. Medium is a fancy word for the material or substance through which a wave is traveling. Air is typically the medium for situations involving sound waves, but sound waves can travel through all kinds of different materials, like water, metal, or even human flesh and bone. And the fact that sound can travel through human flesh and bone explains something you might have always wondered about. Which is, why do our voices sound so different on audio and video recordings? The reason for this is that when we're speaking to someone, we actually hear two contributions from our voice. We hear the sound wave traveling out of our mouth, through the air, and into our ear. But we also hear the vibration of the sound wave traveling through our flesh and bone, through our skull, and into our eardrum. But on an audio or video recording, the only part that's recorded is the sound that travels through the air. So when you hear your voice played back on an audio recording, you only hear what other people hear when they listen to you.
Next topic is characteristics of wave motion. In the characteristics of wave motion, we can see that in a wave motion, only energy is transferred and not the particles. Second one, the velocity of the wave motion is different from the velocity of the vibrating particle. Third one, the propagation of a mechanical wave is the medium that possesses the properties of inertia, elasticity, uniform density, and minimum friction among the particles.
Fill half of a trough with water and place some crumbled paper balls in it. Then make ripples on the surface of water using fingers. The disturbance travels on the surface of water in concentric circles of ever-increasing radius till they strike the boundary of the trough. Now the paper balls move up and down as the wave passes, but the balls do not travel along with the wave. Here the water particles move up and down about their mean position without displacement in the direction of propagation of wave. When still water is disturbed, the particles of water begin to vibrate about their mean position at the point of disturbance. These particles collide with the neighboring particles and impart some of their energy to their neighboring particles. As a result of this, the neighboring particles start vibrating about their mean position. Now these particles transfer their energy to the next particle, which in turn begins to vibrate. This process continues and the energy is transferred from one particle to other particle of the medium. Such motion is wave motion. Wave motion is the propagation of disturbances produced on one part of a medium by the vibration of its particles to all its other parts. Waves transfer energy from one position to another position of the medium and not the matter.
Types of waves. In the types of mechanical waves, there are two types of mechanical waves. They are, one is transverse wave, another one is longitudinal wave. Transverse wave is a wave particle of a medium that vibrate in a direction which is perpendicular to the direction of the propagation of the wave. For example, waves in the strings, light waves, etc. Transverse waves are produced only in solids and liquids. In longitudinal wave, okay, the particles of the medium vibrate in a direction which is parallel to the direction of the propagation of the wave. For example, waves in the strings, sound waves in a medium. Longitudinal waves are produced in solids, liquids, and also in gases. Next topic is properties of sound. All sound that we hear are not the same. There are some particles or properties that differentiate one kind of sound from the other. First one, loudness. Second one, pitch. Third one is quality or timbre. Let us see one by one. First one, loudness. Loudness, it is defined as the characteristics of a sound that enables to distinguish a weak or sound from a loud sound. The loudness of the sound depends on its amplitude. Higher the amplitude, louder will be the sound, and vice versa. When the drums is softly beaten, we can hear the sound is produced. When a drums is softly beaten, a weak sound is produced. However, when it is beaten strongly, a loud sound is produced as we hear. The unit of loudness of the sound is decibel. What it is? Decibel. It is written as dB. Second one is pitch. The pitch is the characteristics of the sound that enables us to distinguish between the flat sound and the shrill sound. Okay. The pitch is the characteristics of the sound that enables us to distinguish from the flat sound and the shrill sound. If higher the frequency of the sound, higher will be the pitch. High pitch adds shrillness to the sound. The sound produced by the whistle, a bell, flute and a violin are of high pitch sounds. Normally, the voice of the female has higher pitch than the male. That's why female voice is shriller than the male's voice. Some examples are roar of the lion on the beating of the drums. Okay. Third one, quality or timbre. In the quality, we can see that the quality or timbre is the characteristics of a sound that enables to distinguish between two sounds which have the same pitch and amplitude. For example, in an orchestra, the sound produced by many musical instruments may have the same pitch and loudness. So, you can distinctly identify the sound produced by each instrument. Okay. Next topic is audibility and the range. In audibility and the range, it depends on the frequency. We can classify the sound into three types. They are audible sound, infrasonic sound and ultrasonic sound. First one, audible sound. In the audible sound with a frequency ranging from 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz is called sonic sound or audible sound. Sound with the frequency range alone can be heard by the human beings. Human ears cannot hear sounds from frequencies below 20 Hz or above 20,000 Hz. The above range is called as audible range of sound. Okay. Next topic is infrasonic sound. What do you mean by that? In the infrasonic sound, a sound at the frequency below 20 Hz is called as subsonic or infrasonic sound. Humans cannot hear the sound of this frequency, but some animals like dog, dolphin can hear. Okay, uses of infrasonic sound are: it is employed in the earth monitoring system and it is used in the study of the mechanism of human heart. Okay, third one is ultrasonic sound. In ultrasonic sound, a sound with the frequency greater than 20,000 hertz is called ultrasonic sound. Animals such as bats, dogs, dolphins are able to hear these kinds of ultrasonic sound as well. Okay, uses of ultrasonic sound. It is extensively used in medical applications like sonogram, which is used in the sonar system to detect the depth of the sea and detect enemy submarines. And it is also used in the employed in dishwashers. Another very important application of ultrasound is Galton's whistle. This whistle is inaudible to the human ear, but it can be heard by the dogs, which is used to train the dogs for investigation purpose. Okay. Next topic is musical instruments. In musical instruments, some sounds are pleasing to the ear and make us very happy. The sound that provides a pleasing sensation to hear is called as what? Music. Music is produced by the regular patterns of vibrations. Musical instruments are categorized into four types. What are they? First one, wind instruments. Second one, reed instruments. Third one, stringed instruments. Fourth one, percussion instruments. Now we are in Music Academy.
Produces the sound. Then listen here the music. You can see here the percussion instrument, and this is the oldest instrument, and that is the drums and tabla. Okay, and drums, you can see this is the hollow box, okay, which is covered by the membrane, and this is called as a resonator. Once we hit the membrane, we can hear the sound and it vibrates and produces the sound.
First one, wind instruments. In the wind instrument, the sound is produced by the vibration of the air in the hollow tube. The frequency is varied by the air column, like trumpet, flute, shenai and saxophone are some of the examples for the wind instruments. Next one is reed instruments. In a reed instrument, it contains a reed. Okay, air which is blown through the instrument, in this instrument, it causes the reed to vibrate, which in turn produces the specific sound. For example, harmonium and mouth organ. This you know very well. Okay, third one, stringed instruments. In the stringed instruments, make use of string or wire to produce a vibration, and hence the specific sound is produced. These instruments also have hollow boxes that produces the sound that is produced here. The frequency of the sound is varied by varying the length of the vibrating wire. For example, violin, guitar are some of the examples of the stringed instruments. A guitar string has a number of frequency at which it is naturally vibrate. These naturally frequencies are the harmonies of the guitar string. Okay. Next one is percussion instruments. In the percussion instruments produces a specific sound when they struck or scrapped or clashed together. They are the oldest type of the musical instruments. Percussion instruments like the drums and tabla consist of leather membrane which is stretched across the hollow box which is called as the resonator. The membrane is heated, it starts vibrating and produces the sound. Next topic is sound produced by the humans. Sound produced by humans, yes. In human beings, the sound is produced in the voice box called larynx, which is present in the throat. It is located in the upper part of the windpipe. The larynx has two ligaments called vocal cords. Okay, the vocal cords have a narrow slit through which the air is blown in and out. When a person speaks, the air from the lungs is pushed out through the trachea to the larynx. When this air passes through the slit, the vocal cords begins to vibrate. You can even check and produces a sound. By varying the thickness of the vocal cord, the length of the air column in the slit can be changed. This produces the sound of different pitches. Males generally have thicker and longer vocal cords that produces deeper. Okay. The pitch sound is comparison with the female. This is explained very clearly about the sound produced by the human beings. Next topic is mechanism of human ear. In the mechanism of ears, ear is the important organ for all animals to hear the sound. We are able to hear the sound through our ears. Human ear picks up and interrupts the high frequency vibrations. Ears of aquatic animals are designed to pick up the high frequency vibration in water. The outer and the visible part of the human ear is called as pinna. It is specially designed to gather and sound from the environment when it reaches the eardrum through the air canal. When the sound wave strikes the drum, the ossicles move inward and outwards to create the vibration. These vibrations are then picked by the special types of cells in the inner ear. From the inner ear, the vibrations are sent to the brain to inform the signal. The brain perceives the signal as sound. This is the mechanism of human ears. Next important topic is about noise pollution. In the noise pollution, uses of loudspeakers, crackers during the festivals also contributes the noise pollution. The major source of noise pollution is from the industries. Noise pollution is the byproduct of the industrialization. Any sound which is unpleasant to hear is called as what? Noise. It is the unwanted, irritating and louder sound. Noise is produced by the irregular and non-periodic vibration. Generally, noise gives us stress. The disturbance produced in the environment by loud sound from various sources is called as what? Noise pollution. Busy roads, aeroplanes, mixer grinders, washing machine and radio, all these causes the noise pollution. These are the major sources of noise pollution. Health hazards due to the noise pollution. Yes, noise creates some of the health hazards to us. Noise may cause irritation, stress, nervousness and headache. Long-term exposure to noise may change the sleeping pattern of a person. And sustained exposure to noise may affect the hearing ability, Sometimes it leads to a loss of hearing also. Sudden exposure to louder noise may cause heart attack and unconsciousness. It causes lack of concentration in one's work. Noise of horns, loudspeaker, causes disturbances leading to lack of concentration. Noise pollution mainly affects a person a peace of mind. Next topic is controlling of noise pollution. How noise pollutions can be reduced? Noise pollutions can be reduced by adopting some steps. Strict guidelines should be set for the use of the loudspeakers on social and religious occasions. And all automobiles should have effective silencers. Third point, people should be encouraged to refrain from excessive honking while driving. Fourth one, industrial machines and home appliances should be properly maintained. All communication system must be operated in low volume. Residential areas should be free from heavy vehicles. Next point, green corridor belt should be set up around the industries as per the regulations of the Pollution Control Board. People working in noisy factories should wear the earplugs. People should be encouraged to plant more trees to absorb the materials like curtains, cushions in their home. By following this, we can reduce the noise pollution to the maximum level. Next topic is hearing loss. In hearing loss, we may have hearing loss without realizing it. Okay, first one, ear ache. Okay, that is pain. A feeling of fullness of fluid in the ear. Ringing in your ears, hearing loss is caused by various reasons. Some of them are aging, age factor, ear infections if it is not treated properly, and certain medicines, and genetic disorder, a severe blow to the head, and loud noise. These are the causes of the hearing loss. Thank you, children. We'll meet you in the next session.